الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين. يا رب، يا من تنزهت عن الشريك ذاتك وعن الشبيه صفاتك، يا واحدا لا من قلة، ويا موجودا لا من علة، يا من أجبت دعاء نوح فانتصر وحملته في فلكك المشحون، ويا من أحال النار حول خليله روحا وريحانا بقولك كوني، ويا من أمرت الحوت يلفظ يونسا وسترته بشجيرة اليقطين، يا رب إنا مثله في قربة فارحم عبادا كلهم ذنوني. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الرحمن، علم القرآن، خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، كان أقل الناس كلامًا وأكثرهم فكرًا وذكرًا. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه كان يقول: من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيراً أو ليصمت. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك وأنعم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدرهم ومقدارهم العظيم، وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وارضى عنا معهم يا رب العالمين، آمين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our dear children, it is my honor to welcome you all to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make all of us among those about whom Allah says, وَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِي الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Which means, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give good news to those when they listen to a word of advice or a sermon, they follow the best of it. My dear brothers and sisters, the greatest gift ever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed on mankind is the gift of self-expression, is to express yourself, what you feel inside and what you think about and what you need from others. The gift of how to convey that in a language, in words, so we can understand what you are feeling or what you want and what is your need, so we can relate to one another. So that is the greatest gift. No wonder Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ar-Rahman, the surah that had 31 times verse to say, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Which one of your Lord's favor you deny or reject? So one of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the best favor after the creation is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الرحمن علم القرآن. Before Allah created man, even Allah in his divine will decreed that he is sending to us the Quran and make the Quran easy to be recited and to be understood. علم القرآن خلق الإنسان. So Allah did not create man then to think about what should we do with him. Before he was created, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planned everything for him. خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. البيان means to convey my need to you brothers and sisters. So without that, all of us will be mute. All of us, we don't talk. We are silent. So it is the best favor ever that by which people express their love, people express their need, people convey the information. And we are living in a time of sharing a lot of information by the media, a lot of outlet of media. Nowadays they call it social media. But we as Muslims, we have to understand that with each favor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed on us, there is a responsibility. So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, be careful the way you use your tongue, the way you express yourself, the way you talk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ Two eyes, وَلِسَانًا and one tongue, وَشَفَتَيْنِ and two lips. One tongue. Can you imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us two tongues? How will be our situation? One tongue can make the whole world upside down. Even one word, not even 8 billion tongues, one tongue can destroy the whole world. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us two lips, two gates. So if there is no use for that tongue, we close the gate. The gate is to protect me from others and protect others from me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we're gonna say, we cannot help. Our tongue is free, is unleashed, is very extended. The way it works. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have two lips. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. So sometimes we think that talking has nothing to do with religion. I'm a good Muslim. I read the Quran, I memorize the Quran, I made the Salah, the Nawafil, I make the Hajj, I'm good Muslim, I'm practicing Muslim. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam connect using our tongue with Iman, with faith. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't speak on his own or hawa. And doesn't speak out of uselessness. He mean what he says. Whoever believe in Allah and the last day, whoever believe that Allah is watching, Allah is hearing, Allah is seeing. Don't we read in Allah Sami'un Basir? Allah is all hearing, all seeing. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر. Why يوم آخر? Why إيمان بالله is not enough? Because in the last day when we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're gonna have a lot of surprises. Amazing things will happen. That the word, every word we utter is gonna be written. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. everything that we say is written down. Just like they say, you have the right to stay silent, to keep silent. Anything you say, it can and will be used against you. This is when the cop come to arrest somebody. He have to read to him that law, the Fifth Amendment. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say, it can and will be used against you. In Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, be careful what you say. A word can make you go to Jannah. Another word can make the person become cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We read, brothers and sisters, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about some people, not even Muslims. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا آمَنَّا فَاكْتُبْنَا مَعَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. In the end of the verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَثَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِمَا قَالُوا. Because their acknowledgement and their confession that they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they ask Allah to forgive them, the priests and the clergy of the people of the book, when they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, Rabbana amanna, our Lord we believe. Because of that word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَثَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِمَا قَالُوا جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِ مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Because of what they have said, Allah rewarding them with Jannat. Not one Jannah, but with Jannat. Because of what? What did they do? Did they make Hajj? Did they make, give Zakah? Did they make anything? No. Just a word. A word of Iman. Make them rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Jannat. On the contrary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the same surah, وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا. Some of the people of the book being cursed for what they have said. What did they say? يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ. The hands of Allah are tied up. Allah is miser, doesn't want to give. إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَقِيرٌ وَنَحْنُ أَغْنِيَاءٌ. Allah doesn't want to give because he doesn't have. We are richer than him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا. Allah cares them for what they have said. This means be careful, brothers and sisters. Whatever we say, we have to be careful. لِسَانُ الْفَتَى نِصْفٌ وَنِصْفٌ فُؤَادُهُ فَلَمْ يَبْقَ إِلَّا صُورَةُ اللَّحْمِ وَالدَّمِ. We are about our tongue. If our language is decent, is meaningful, we are civilized. And you can judge any society, any person, any family, any community by the way they talk. When their talk is in vain, useless talk, nonsense, a lot of talk, big talkers, you know they are not civilized. Because if they are civilized, they should get busy with their own selves, by working, by establishment. But those who are very little in talk, they're gonna be working so effectively. So that is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came, Mu'adh radiallahu anhu was asking him several questions. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَى مِلَاكِ ذَلِكَ كُلِّهِ يَا مُعَاد. Shall I tell you with the control of everything in Islam, in jihad, in zakah, in hajj, in iman? He said, بَلَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, أمسك عليك هذا. Keep this tongue under control. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم brought us the best wisdom ever. Because the time I talk, I utter the word, it is out. You cannot bring it back. You cannot say, wait a minute, I was wrong. I know it means bad. I want it back. It is over. And it is written. It is written. That now we regret saying what I have said. I wish I never said it. Because that word is very effective. So Mu'adh said, Ya Rasulallah, أَوَإِنَّا لَمُؤَخَذُونَ بِمَا نَتَكَلَّمُ بِهِ. Are we accountable for our utterance? We talk a lot. Is that a part of our faith? Is that going to be used against us? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَكِلَتْكَ أُمُّكَ يَا مُعَادِ وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسَ فِي النَّارِ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. I thought you know better than that, Mu'az. What make people then go thrown on their faces on the hellfire? If it is not for their tongue. Because one word, brothers and sisters, gonna give encouragement, gonna make person feel worthy. One word. Even if the person is dying and tell him, you look so and so, today you look amazing. You look great. You know, and you tell him, Allah is so loving, Allah is so merciful. Allah has miracles every day in our life. You are giving him encouragement, even if he's dying tomorrow. But when you see a person and tell him, I'm sorry, you know, your situation is very bad, you make him feel down. You are breaking his spirit and his morale. That is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you visit a person who is sick, إِذَا زُرْتُمُ الْمَرِيضِ فَنَفِّسُوا لَهُ فِي الْأَجَلِ. سبحان الله. When you visit somebody, nafis means, tell him, you gonna live longer. You are so good. You look nice. You gonna outlive all of us. It is a word. And I'm not a professional in medicine. I do not know. Even if I'm the best doctor, Allah knows when he or she is gonna die. But the good word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ibrahim, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةً أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. The good word is like a strong tree, deeply rooted in the ground and branches out in the sky. تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا. Give its fruit. Anytime Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fruits of the good word is iman, is faith, is reconciliation, is love, is unity, is establishment, is family getting it together, is forgiving one another, is speaking decent about one another, encouragement. But the ugly word, وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ. The word khabitha means smell bad, look ugly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the word. The word cannot be described as khabitha or good. It is a word. It is a verb or a noun, a sentence, some letters. That's the word. You cannot describe waw or mim or alif or lam as good or bad. You cannot describe it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to make us abhor and hate to utter a bad word. Because uttering a bad word is just like some bad, smell bad, ugly thing come out of my mouth. كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ اجْتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ. So one word you can reconcile the family, one word. Divorce take place. What is the divorce? A person to say to his wife, "Anti talaq," is done. What is zawaj? Marriage.
I agree to marry this or to make this husband for that. Give you my daughter, that is it. Documentation is confirmation, but it is a word. What is Iman? Is a word. وألزمهم كلمة التقوى. الله كل لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله as كلمة. Even they say the كلمة means the شهادة. It is a word you say. What is كفر? Is a word. So that is why, brothers and sisters, we have to be careful what we say. Because the word can make a community, can make peace, a treaty, and one word can make a war. What is war? It is a decree, a decision signed by a president to go to attack another country. It is a signature. And when people vote, when they vote, I agree, it is a word. So that is why the word has a power. And that power is very, very effective. More than the weapon of mass destruction. More than nuclear bomb. Because that word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala write it down. And when we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll see the result of it. While reading about that subject, I came to Surah Al-Mu'minun and Surah Al-Shura. Wherever you read in the Quran, Allah connects Salah with Zakah. Nothing to separate them. أَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Always in the Quran. There is more about 29 verses in the Quran connect Salah with Zakah, no barrier between them. In 15 surah, except 2 verses in 2 surah, Allah separate between them. Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah 23, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Who are they? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Where is Zakah? Coming after that. There is something important than Zakah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. What separate between Salah and Zakah is اللغو. اللغو means be careful. You make your Salah, you give khushu, then before jumping to Zakah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to say, be careful with the laghu. You did very well in Salah, but that laghu is going to make you lose the benefit of Salah. What is the meaning of Salah when assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum, and start picking up the phone and talking bad about somebody? Trying to scandal or to cast somebody out of God's mercy, or to curse him, or to backbite him, or to make rumors about him. What all that information I'm sending? They are recorded, and you're gonna see it on the day of judgment. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the well-known hadith, "Atadruna man al-muflis." We work hard to be good Muslims. We read the Quran, we make salah, we give zakah, we try to behave nicely, but we cannot lose what we have worked for things are very, very little. We look at it as very little, but they are destructive for our worship. We wake up at night in Ramadan, we fast, we deprive ourselves from the water and drink. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ الصِّيَامُ عَنِ الطَّعَامِ وَالشَّرَابِ إِنَّمَا الصِّيَامُ عَنِ اللَّهُوَ وَالرَّفَثِ. Useless talk. The talk has no meaning. That is why قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّهُوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. They turn away from Allah. When somebody wants to have useless talk, entertaining one another on somebody's account, that is lahu. Be careful with that. That is the first place in the Quran, one of the two, that separate between the twins, between Salah and Zakah. The second one in Surah Ash-Shura. The importance of the Shura. الذين استجابوا لربهم وأقاموا الصلاة. وين الزكاة؟ Wait a minute. وأمرهم شورى بينهم ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it that way to indicate the importance of what we say. So that is why, brothers and sisters, a little word make a big difference. Before we regret, before we think that has nothing, it is just, you know, a talk. No. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Muflis, the bankrupt, who will come with a lot of good deeds. He was the best Muslim practicing Islam. Salah, zakah, hajj, reading, siyam, all of that. But at the same time come, shatama hada, wasabba dak, backbite this, insult that, bad mouth this, spread rumor, misinformation about somebody, attacking his integrity, accusing him of something. All of that is words, are destroying our, deleting our good deeds. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون أو كما قال ادعوا الله يستجب لكم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونتوكل عليه ونستزيده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله السميع البصير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا البشير النذير اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam and Quran always invite us to be the best and to say the best. To be the best example for Islam by saying what is best. Few verses in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله تقوى. We think that taqwa is just, you know, the way I pray, khushu, all of that. No. Taqwa, that is one of the aspects of taqwa. But taqwa has a lot to do with something else. اتقوا الله. وقولوا قولا سديدا. Speak right. Speak to the point. Sadid means say the truth, they say what is good, what is right, and what is true. قولوا قولا سديدا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وقل لهما قولا كريما. Honorable. Speak to them with honorable term. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا حَضَرَ الْقِسْمَةَ أُولُو الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ فَارْزُقُوهُمْ مِنْهُ وَقُولُوا لَهُمْ قَوْلًا مَعْرُوفًا. قَوْلًا مَعْرُوفًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنَ. Say to my servant to speak what is better. Not even good, but what is better. If you have two words, both are good, choose the one that is best. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in matter of da'wah, no way to get excited and carried away and think I'm the only Muslim, I'm the only one right. No, even if you are, doesn't matter whom you are talking to a drunk, to a bad, to a kafir, to a fasiq, the language make miracles. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa and Harun, اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى. How to talk to him, ya Rab? فقول له قولا لينا. Speak to him nicely, softly. لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. اللهم اغفر بفضلك للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا عيبا إلا سترته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا حاجة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، أسأل الله الكريم رب العرش العظيم أن يغفر لي ولكم ولأمة محمد أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.